Hi, I'm Shane Hudson, your host for Soul and Fit Tips, where we answer questions from you regarding health and fitness issues. Today, we're going to be discussing water activities, and I have on board Paula, who's an expert in this area. Paula, thank you for joining us. Paula, you know, I get questions all the time regarding type of activities that can be done in the water that cater to fitness. In particular, we're looking at flexibility issues, we're looking at cardio issues, and also strength and conditioning. You got any tips or advice that you can give those who in those particular areas?
Oh, absolutely. Thank you for joining me in the pool for a change. This is a wonderful medium for people to exercise because it's easier on their joints, and they could do some movements that they can't actually accomplish on land. So it really makes a good medium. And it's supportive, yet it's resistant, because when you push on the water harder, then it gives you the resistance. But if you need the support, then it's there to support you at the same time. So that's a great way to think of the water. You could do a lot of things in the water. Cardio workout is great. There's some basic movements that you can do and just get a really great cardio workout. Why don't you get jogging? Just jog. Now, when you jog on land, you go heel to toe, but you want it in the water, the faster you go, you want to go toe to heel, and that gets you a little bit more speed. Okay, and just get those legs moving. Okay, now we're going to bring your knee up in front and try to reach it with your opposite hand. Okay, it's just a little jump, and you just get that turn in the torso and get your spine a little bit loosened up, get a little bit more aerobic capacity there. Okay, and that also works with the hamstrings, but now we're gonna go for the quads by bringing your foot up on the side and touch down with your hand on the side. Try to touch your heel. There you go. This is a great way to warm up in the water, and then you could go to bigger movements with longer levers, they call them. Okay, now we're gonna go with a longer lever, and we're gonna do a cross country. So one foot is forward with the opposite hand, okay, and the back is extended. And you wanna extend your back hand, beautiful. And you wanna get your heels down, both in the front and in the back. And there's a tendency to wanna stay up on the toes, isn't there, Shane?
Like lunging.
Yes, yes, yes. Great. Okay, now let's try some jumping jacks. So all you're gonna do, you're not gonna bring your arms out of the water, you're just gonna bring them up to the surface and then down by your sides. Arms out, legs out. Great. Okay, now we're gonna throw one at you. This is a mind and body connection. We're gonna go with arms out and legs in, and then switch them. So it's a jumping jack with opposite arms. My classes hate this one. Good. All right, now we're gonna get a little more spinal rotation, and I want you to just jump one side to the other and then twist your shoulders to the opposite side. Just twist it out. Great. Okay. And let's go back to elbow to knee. So if you just repeat these exercises and just do them in a rotation, then you can get a real good workout, and you're using all of your muscles. All right, let's go for heels up on the side and touch down with your hand. So go back to that one. Great, and now cross country. So that's straight legs, heels are down, both the front and back. Great. And now jumping jacks. You feeling warmed up?
I'm feeling warm.
Oh, great. Okay, let's go to opposite arms on those jumping jacks. So make a T and then switch everything. It's funny how your mind wants to do the opposite. Great job. Great. OK, Okay, and now you can cool it down. We're going to cool it down by doing a jump rope. So you're just going to bring your feet off the ground and just twirl your arms like you had a jump rope. And that loosens up your lower back. If you've been doing cardio for a little bit, you might feel a little bit of pressure there. Do you feel it in your lower back a little bit?
It feels really good.
Okay, good. Good. All right. Great job. Okay, would you like to do some strength training?
You betcha.
I think you would.
I'm all warmed up.
All right. You can find these really cheaply at the store. This is a noodle. They call it a pool noodle, and they're usually around a dollar. You could use that to get a little bit of work with your legs and your arms, and also your torso. All right, first I'm going to have you place it under your foot, under one foot. Okay. All right, and stand up as straight as you can and bring that knee up and down in front. This is like a leg press for one leg.
Oh, I like this.
Isn't that nice? You want to try to keep your foot at a right angle, so extend your foot out just a little bit, and then the noodle won't bump you. If you find the noodle bumping you, then you know you're too close with your foot. Good. All right, now bring your knee up to the level of your hip. And now take your knee out to the side. Just rotate it out and bring it back in. Now this is a core workout as well as an inner thigh workout. If you have trouble with this, you could hang on to the back of the pool behind you. And that makes it a little bit more of a thigh workout. But if you stay in the center and keep trying to keep yourself centered, then you get more of an ab workout with it. All right, we're doing the other side. Great. So we're going out and in. Great. Okay, now you're going to take the noodle off of your foot, and we're going to put it behind you. Okay, and then just hold on to it with your shoulders relaxed, and just squat down a little bit with your knees bent, and now twist. So your feet are going to stay solid on the ground. If your feet want to come up, then you know you're not holding your abdominals in hard enough. Okay. And this is a good golfing exercise too, because it gives that spinal rotation. And you could even keep your head center and work on that neck, trying to keep your eye on the ball. All right. Great. Okay, now we did an elbow to knee in the front, so now I want you to use the noodle and reach up with your opposite knee, bring your knee up, and then touch it with the noodle, and you get a little bit more of the side. Yeah. Great. So that gets you across in the center, but now you could reach down on the same side and just bring your foot up, mimicking the thing we did with the heels on the side in our cardio segment. And you feel that more in your side too. Okay, good. If you lean into it, then you'll get a little bit more. There we go. All right, great. Okay, now I want you to bring the noodle around to the front. So we did a little bit of spinal work and some abdominals, some legs. Now take the noodle out to the front, and I want you to tie it in a knot. So just make a balloon animal. Okay. All right. Now I want you to hold the humps on the top, the two humps, okay, and squat down. With your elbows next to your body, you want to come up and down, and this is for your triceps. All right. And if you want to take that for a little bit longer workout, you could say the alphabet. So you could just actually spell out the alphabet with the noodle in that position. And then you'll get 26 minutes of exercise. Great. Okay. All right. Now I want you to undo the noodle, good. All right, now we're gonna put it on your leg again, and we're gonna do some flexibility. Actually, I want it under your ankle so that it lifts your leg. And now you can let go of the noodle with your hands and let it float your leg up. And this is a wonderful hamstring stretch. So you could stand up nice and tall and then lean forward into it and you get a great stretch. Doesn't that feel good?
Very good.
That feels better than any hamstring stretch on land, doesn't it?
Yes, I like that.
All right.
Supports you.
It sure does.
Place more emphasis on this stretch.
It sure does. And here's a stretch that you can't get on land either. Now stand up nice and tall. Keep the noodle there. Okay, now rotate your foot out to the side and you'll get an inner thigh stretch that you can't get on land. Not even in yoga class. Not this intense anyway. All right. And if you want it to be even more intense, you could lean into the noodle on the side and you really feel it. Good. All right, and then we'll just finish that off by holding onto the noodle and pressing your foot back for a calf stretch. All right, and Shane, there's another thing we could do with another household product that we have that you could work on your strengthening. These are orange juice bottles. There's a lot of jugs that come in this shape. If you fill them with water, they become a water weight. And you don't have to worry about them rusting. And they're easy to carry home also. So you just fill them up. That one, I believe, is 4 pounds if it was filled up. And then you just put the cap back on. All right, and you're going to hold it by the cap on the top. And we're going to do some tricep exercises. So hoist it over your head. There you go. And then bring your elbows close to your head. And you can do both arms at the same time. Good. And then just come up and down. And that's an awesome tricep exercise. You want to make sure you hold your abdominals in on this one. Some people tend to sway their back a little bit. But you really feel the triceps more when you hold those abdominals in, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Great. Okay, let's bring those down in front. And we're going to now hold them vertically upside down. Okay, great. And now it becomes a rotary chest. So those are some things you could do with something that's absolutely free, and it's recycling too. So that's another benefit of it.
Thank you, Paula.
Welcome.
And thank you for being with us. Join us next week for another Soul and Fit Tip. I'm Shane Hudson, exhorting you to take charge of your health.